Hey Sean, this is Troy from Managed Design. I just wanted to send you a quick video here to kind of showcase what we had spoke about and some of the things that we can do for you. I'm hoping that we can help you guys use your existing workflows and maybe digitize them, and hopefully things will go faster and the quality can go up and everybody's speaking the same language and marking up the drawings using the same tools. So real quick here, I've got a steel frame that I, PDF that I have printed, and I went through with my tools over here. And again, we talked about splitting these up by, W16s, maybe all in a tool chest or some way to break these apart. We'll have to readdress that because I know you guys need everything from the steel book. So, yeah, we can talk about that, but I just created a handful of them here to cover what I have on this drawing. I basically replaced all of your highlighters with the color, and then I replaced your calculator by, you know, you don't have to do this math for the hypotenuse anymore. I can come in here, grab my WT, zoom in, snap to the intersections there and draw that line in there. Okay, and then come down here, same thing, pick the W or the double angle and click and draw over top of that. Okay, so I'm gonna finish up a couple of these markups here and show you the custom columns that I've created based on our conversations and kind of how I understand it. The little bit that we've spoke, just went in and did those W21 by 44s. I'm going to show you the tools, the custom columns now. When I look down here, what I created for you was the label, which we can make, we can have that show up on plan as well. It's just going to show up over top of these that are already drawn here. So either way, we can manipulate that. It's giving you the length of each one of the beams. I created a custom column for pounds plus 10%. So that's giving you the weight of that beam with 10%. I can then come in here and double click on the end, the left end, and set this. I don't necessarily know what all of these abbreviations mean, but I grabbed those from the documentation you gave me. So I can set both ends. I put choices in here for the grade of steel. I also put choices for the finish. You can add notes and labor codes, assemblies, all of that for each of these beams. And then what we can do is export that, and I'll show you that in a second. So as you try to fill in each of these custom columns with information per these, for the, each of these beams, there are ways to speed that up a little bit. I'm going to come up here and show you the 16 by 26. Go ahead and trace that. And then what I want to do is, because I know I have a bunch of them, I'm going to grab that and come over to my properties over here. I'm going to go ahead and change my mark end and my right end. We can rename those however you see fit. Grade 50, I put those as a default on the wide flanges. And the finish, I'll change to primer. Labor code, we want copes. So now that I've changed that on here, I can grab this one and hold my control key and drag it over. Then I'm gonna hold my shift key and grab the two of them. Again, drag it over, make a copy. And then I can hold my shift key and grab all four. Copy it down here. And then I'm also going to copy that down to this lower bay. And I'll grab a separate one here. Cover these. Okay, and then what you'll notice is because I filled in those parameters and then copied it, if I look at my 16 by 26s, it filled in all of that information for me on all of those. So there's ways of either changing these ahead of time before you copy them. We can set these defaults however you want. I just left them blank so that we know they haven't been thought out yet. You have to select them to kind of show that they're complete. I can also come in here and grab these 18 by 35s using my shift key, select all of those, and come over here and change the parameters on those as well, by grouping it in the markups list. Okay, so once I have all my information down here filled in, then I can go ahead and do my summary to CSV. I think for you importing into your, if I remember right, you're going to import into another software for estimating. So you can decide whether or not you want to show the column headers. I'll turn it on, just say okay. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. And it'll open it up and show you what the end result is for all those beams that we covered. So this is what I'm proposing for, I guess, just an initial throw of ideas at your workflow. Obviously, we can tweak this and make it work for you guys. This was just my 5-minute conversation with you and my experience kind of pulling it together to try to show you roughly what we can do. We can take it a ways further than that too. Just let me know. So thanks again, Sean, for your time. I will hopefully speak to you soon. Thank you, sir.